Hi, thanks for tuning in. In this lesson, I'm again going to compare a couple of features between Magento and Shopware. So if you're a Magento developer, hopefully I'm going to tell you a couple of things that are nice to know about Shopware 6 before getting started with a real project. And in this lesson, I'm actually going to focus upon the database. And if you're a Magento developer, then you should be smiling already a little bit, because obviously we're also going to talk about that thing called EAV. So the database of Magento is based upon EAV. You'll know about it as soon as you open up the database with some kind of management tool. All of the different values attached to attributes, attached to entities, are all chopped up into little tables, meaning also that a single fetch of all of the different products out there is leading into select queries with a lot of joins with a lot of other tables. Then basically Shopware is going to be a breeze, because Shopware tends to use flat tables, so single tables relating to single entity. It doesn't mean that things are not getting more complex, because there's other concepts like entity extensions and custom fields and etc., so that you as a third-party developer can add additional information on top of existing entities without actually modifying the existing tables of that entity. But it still boils down to, well, a lot more simplicity compared to Magento itself. So Magento is using EAV, Shopware is tending to use flat tables. But there's more to tell about the differences as well. For instance, every table usually also has a primary key. Within Magento, that's always a numeric primary key, simply a number referring to whatever. And then actually the number is normally incremented for every time when you need to add a new entity or a new row to that table. Which makes it also kind of easy to compare different tables. So even though EAV, as mentioned before, is kind of complex, as soon as you open up the database and you start gathering all of the tables related to entities and all of the tables related to the values and attributes, it's kind of like still doable to keep track of those numbers, because often you're looking at numbers like 42 and etc. So it's kind of like easy to keep track of. And while Shopware, its table structure is a lot simpler because it's using flat tables, suddenly actually Shopware makes it a little bit more difficult by using UUIDs. So they're not making use of primary keys, auto-increment fields. Instead, every entity, every row in a specific table is accompanied with this UUID, a combination of numbers and characters and letters, I should say. And then basically these UUIDs are 16-bit numbers or 16-bit strings that are kind of like harder to remember. Often what I do is I try to take a look at the last three or four numbers or the three or four characters of that UUID to give me an impression of what kind of ID is that. But it's not a real strong fail-safe, and therefore it's a little bit harder to do this. Why has Shopware used those UUIDs? Well, there's a full story behind it, but bottom line is it really makes all of those IDs uniquely identifiable. There's this little helper function called UUID randomize to allow you to put together your own UUID, and as soon as you're importing data, like importing products, you're going to make use of that function. But in general, this is really something that is different between Magento and Shopware, and you need to know you need to know about it, but also get the hang of it if you're coming from Magento. There's another thing for the table usage. So I've just mentioned already that Magento is using EAV to also store entities. With Shopware, we talk about entities being saved into a single table, so flat table. But then the question is also, what else is out there that is also known as an entity? In another lesson, I'm actually going to focus strongly upon what is in that database and what kind of tables are interesting. That's beyond the comparison between Magento and Shopware. But it's already good to know that actually, for instance, translations are kept in a separate table instead. And actually the translation itself is known as a translation entity on top of the translation or the original entity. So for instance, if you're translating a product, that product is an entity stored in a specific table called, product. But then there's a product underscore translations table that is maintaining all of these different translation entities of a specific product. And logically, one single product could have many translations, many different views upon that same product. And therefore, also the architecture of EAV boils down to be maybe more flexible in Magento, but Shopware has chosen a solution that is also kind of like straightforward. Another lesson is actually going to focus upon indexing in total as well. So there's much more to talk about with indexes, but for now, it's also nice to know that within Magento, indexing is mostly taking place by indexing towards a specific indexing table, a separate table created specifically for that purpose. And with Shopware, that same mechanism sometimes kicks in as well, but sometimes it's just indexing towards a specific column in an existing table. So be aware that actually sometimes you're looking for tables that have the name index in them or something, but those tables are not there. Indexing is just a little bit more done in secret under the hood without you knowing about it. But let's actually discuss more of that in a separate lesson. For now, I've just gone through a couple of features comparing Shopware and Magento regarding their database architecture. And personally, I feel that the Shopware architecture of the database is a lot more simple, a lot more straightforward, but it still allows for a lot of flexibility for extending upon things in a nice way. And I just mentioned something like entity extensions or the custom fields, but there's going to be separate lessons actually diving into those topics as you go along with it. But at least we've figured out a couple of the key differences between Magento and Shopware already. So thanks for listening and keep up the good work and see you in a bit.